I am the Reaper of Monsters, insolent creature.
Son, put it down.
Who did the mustache? Griffin. Griffin, who did the mustache?
Son, this is your last warning. You don't have to do this.
No, you look great. You look.
It's not supposed to be funny.
Come on, Griffin. They're not that bad.
Not that bad. I'm sick of this B-film bullshit, David. Am I not a good enough actor or what? I mean, come on. El Diablo 7. Who saw the first six? Nobody.
What about the trophy you won from the last award season?
Best portrayal of a masked lunatic at the Backwoods Horror Film Festival? Wow, such an achievement for a non-existent career.
Are you saying that I'm a bad agent?
Yes, yes, yes! Dude, you've never gotten me a decent role. One that's not a masked murderer.
Hey, what's got you all riled up? You've been different ever since, you know.
I just need some time, David.
I'll get you something soon. I promise.
This film, Hitched 2, is an aggressively vile, grave departure from the creatively subdued immaturity of the first. I don't recommend it to anyone, not even the...
You make me so happy.
And why did you leave?
Let's not worry about that right now.
You promised me, Eleanor. You promised me you'd tell me if you weren't happy and if I weren't enough for you.
David?
Eleanor?
That is going to hang my posters, my beautiful new posters, in my beautiful new office. But anyway, yeah, I think this is a great opportunity for you.
What? How did I get here?
You actors, always the same. Always in character. The Ballad of Buck Wild. They want you. They called me up after seeing your latest Hitchhiker film.
He's lying. Sorry, did you say something?
They want you. The actor playing the lead villain is in the hospital, terminal or something, but who cares? You got it, pal. And this is good for us.
Us.
This is not the response I was either hoping for nor expected. Yes?
Vera Lovejoy is here to see you, sir.
Send her in, sweetheart.
Sorry, David, I didn't know you had company.
Griffin Gould, I'd like to introduce you to the enchanting, lovely Vera Lovejoy. She'll be your co-star at Buck Wild.
Do I know you?
I'm sorry. I think you might be mistaken.
He's filling in for Arthur.
Oh, poor guy. Hope he feels better. You're just gonna love your part.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Are you ready for tonight, David?
I'm sorry, I'm sorry, my dear. I actually have something that just came up, but Griffin here can take you instead.
Sorry, David, but I can't.
Just a second.
Griffin, come on, dude. You gotta get out there, right? Give her a chance. You know, she's good on her feet, among other things.
Do it. Fine.
Perfect. It's a date then. He'll meet you there tonight, my dear.
Okay.
So, I was thinking.
Good job in there, old friend.
It's you.
Yeah, it is me. You know, I can just go if that's really...
No, please. Don't go.
Whoa. My God, what happened?
A guy? They're not gonna shoot me like this.
No, you'd be surprised what the makeup department can do. Trust me, I basically live there.
Maybe you're right.
Should we go in?
You sure you still want to go with me like this?
party.
Supposedly, Sid wanted to save as much money as possible.
Sid?
Producer.
Typical. Is that why there's nobody here?
Probably. I don't even know most of these people.
So, what got you into show business?
My father, actually. He wanted all of us kids to go into it. My brother, he's a member of the symphony orchestra. My sister, she's a costume designer. And me, well, I guess I'm an actress.
Sounds like a good guy, your father.
Not really. Let's just say I've had bigger bruises than this one. I'm sorry, Griffin. I didn't mean to lay all of that on you like that. Why did you get into it anyways?
Rebellion, I suppose. I don't know, my mother wasn't very supportive of the liberal arts. She was pushing me to be like a doctor or a lawyer, you know, something that was like more realistic.
Let's drink to our parents. I surely hope you're not married.
I was.
She passed last year, so.
Must have been a lucky lady.
I was a lucky one. I just was too blind to see it then, so.
Would you like to accompany me to the dance floor? Sorry, Griffin. Did I do something wrong?
No. You were perfect. You just reminded me of Eleanor.
There's something I need to tell you. The guy who did this to me, it was David.
What?
He's... I'm not supposed to tell you this, but it was all his idea.
Tell me.
David, he's behind all of this. It's all him.
No, I don't follow.
A year ago, David was worried that your wife was getting in the way of your career and his salary. So he staged some photos on the set of Hitch 2 of you and I, except it wasn't you. Anyways, he showed your wife and he told her that you don't love her anymore, and that you would be happier without her.
You were a part of this?
I didn't know I could get you with them. I promise.
Hey, bud.
buddy boy, what are you doing? Why aren't you at your big day? Yeah, I'm a little scared, but what is this, a new character type?
Oh, wait, what's gotten into you?
The truth, David.
I don't know what you're talking about.
My wife, Eleanor. You killed her!
Are you crazy? She killed herself, man.
No, you coerced her to do it. Convinced her I wanted nothing to do with her anymore.
I never
Didn't you?
No, God. Yeah. Fine, yes. But, come on, I was only looking out for your best interests.
My best interest? You thought my wife thinking I'm sleeping around is in my best interest? You conceited sack of shit!
She was smothering you, Griffy.
Come on.
You pushed her to it, Griffin. I merely pulled the rope.
Yeah, maybe.
The truth.
No, Ellie, I'm the guilty one. I should have been there for you, paid more attention, been more supportive, been a better husband.
But you were a great husband. And you still can be again.
Go to sleep, everything is alright.
Just can't live without you.